cold. But then out of the blue, who strolls down the boulevard but you? Your place is closer than mine. Why don't we go there and have some more wine? 'Cause life is for living. Let's see where the sun might lead.
Hello, lovely people. I'm Jessica, and here's a video explaining how chronic illness wisdom can help everyone in our current situation through the medium of delightful nightwear. I hope you find this video helpful. If you enjoy it and you'd like more painful life lessons I've learned packaged in a fun and vintagey way, then please subscribe and consider joining the Calvin's Rose Art Club to support the channel by clicking the join button below. So right now, we're just trying to get through the coronavirus pandemic. I mean, at first, we were all fired up and mobilized. Even if that mobilization meant some people bought 280 rolls of toilet paper. Why? We got our groceries, we did some baking, we made long lists of things to do. We created desks from nothing and started working from home. But now the adrenaline has worn off and wow, who knew doing not much could be so exhausting? Well, actually, as someone who lives with a broken body, I could have told you that was coming. I mean, I'm still really sorry about it though. That exhaustion that you're feeling is a common response to trauma. Every time I have a health crisis or I get really injured, the hardest part is always once the initial ordeal is over. I mean, before that, you're so busy fighting fires and making sure you just get through and dealing with this anguished upheaval right here, right now. You don't have time for feelings, and then boom. Just when you see the light at the end of the tunnel is when things actually get to their hardest, because you can allow yourself to feel now. This is the plateau period, and it sucks. But eventually, life will return to normal, or else there'll be a new normal. Once you're actually there, it doesn't really matter either way. You might not realize it, but what we're going through right now can be categorized as a culturally, psychologically traumatizing situation, because we're all living in a state of extreme uncertainty, and there is absolutely no shame in finding that difficult. Chronic stress impacts on a number of biological processes that disrupt our sleep cycle and keep our cortisol levels high. Being in flight or fight mode is like doing a workout every single day. Take a deep breath. All you have to do right now is concentrate on surviving and helping others to survive. Not pushing yourself to achieve, not using this time productively, not creating masterpieces or saving the world single-handedly. We have long lived in a society that tells us there are only two types of people, the strivers and the shirkers. And our culture tells us there is nothing worse than being idle.
Well, sod that for a load of bananas.
You need one of the key messages of the chronic illness community. Your productivity does not define your worth. Put down that to-do list that only has one thing of 10 crossed off. Stop beating yourself over the head with your textbook. Take a step away from that novel you've decided now is the perfect time to write, and instead, please enjoy a video about pretty nightwear. Look number one features a 1950s white nylon and chiffon nightgown and peignoir set with white stars and blue leaf embroidery. She's an original from the Gotham Girl Stripe brand, a popular American stocking designer. Featuring a fitted waist, soft blue ribbon bow, and trim on the bust and sleeves, and a beautiful chiffon overlay on the bust, I am particularly a fan of this gorgeous puffy sleeves, and wearing this outfit makes me feel like everything is going to do okay. Apparently I'm very easy to please, so. The truth is though, it's too easy to get caught up in tiny problems when there are huge issues facing the world right now, and then you feel guilty for caring about them. Just like when you're recovering from an illness and it's actually the density of your pillow that upsets you the most. It feels safe to focus on the little things. It works the other way around too though. You can bring yourself a lot of joy just with your favourite drink or some pretty nightwear. So just do it, because when all is said and done, a complex pathogen does not judge your productivity, and when you come out the other side, it will have been more important to prioritize your mental health over your achievements. For our second look, please enjoy this late 1950s nightgown from Vanity Fair in soft nylon with ruffles. You'll note a delightful and well-cut bodice with not too much fabric on the bottom, just perfect for relaxing on warm days. And boy, do I know a thing or two about trying to relax when I actually really want to be productive, but my mind and body have close to zero energy. It's been 30 years of trying to learn to live within my limitations, and whilst I can't tell you it gets easier, it's certainly easier than when I tried to push through that block. Trust me, just because you can't get out of bed all day and every piece of clothing falls into the category of pajamas, that has absolutely no bearing on your morality as decided by the capitalist workhorse. Circumstances are outside of your control. Maybe it's your physical health. Maybe it's your mental health. Maybe it's overstimulation of your neuroatypical brain and you just can't take it. Or maybe it's a worldwide pandemic keeping you locked in the house. Regardless, your productivity does not define your worth. You don't need to account for your time. You're allowed to just have fun.
Why? 'Cause life is for living. Let's see where this all might lead. Let's see where this all might lead.
We now come to a beautiful nightgown that, if you've been watching my channel for a while, you'll know is one of my favourites. She's a little different from the two you've already seen. A little darker, a little more elegant, a little more luxurious. This look says, hey, you might also feel mentally healthier for making sure you have a routine and follow a strict schedule of activities, and that's okay too, because we all have different coping mechanisms. This look says, just be who you want to be.
But then out of the blue, who strolls down the boulevard but you?
Oh wow! Jessica has legs. No one saw this coming. It's weird that I'm not wearing a skirt, isn't it? I know. Don't worry though, it's slinky and monogrammed. Still very on brand. And if your brand is also being fancy, but you can't quite work up to your normal levels in fancy, then I highly recommend some slinky pajamas. Because honestly, nothing feels more delightfully decadent. It's also important that we recognise the hard work of those who are continuing to work and keep our countries going. From nurses and doctors to firefighters, food delivery workers and farmers, you're all saving lives. Feeling anxiety is normal right now, and while it's important to feel those feelings, it's also good to let them go. Productive anxiety makes us follow rules about hand washing and staying home, but unproductive anxiety makes you frightened and catastrophize about the future. So give yourself a break and don't push yourself too hard. Find the joy in ordinary life, wear some fun pajamas, and know that just getting by is good enough. I hope you've enjoyed this video. Please subscribe if you haven't already, and I'll see you next time.
It's night in the city, and I'm on my